Well, Dali, I'm here for the book research for Red Hot China, so looking for chili and spicy foods. But of course, in a place like this, I'm not going to avoid to not get to the other things which I'm interested in, for example, the Buddhist temples. And Dali has a pretty interesting one with the three pagodas right here in Zhongsheng Temple, which are, yeah, survivors of the Nanzhao kingdom, of the Dali kingdom, of all of that. This is now the Zhongsheng Temple proper, a whole lot farther, sorry about the shaking, farther up. So, entrance gate, bell and drum tower, and a first main hall. This temple, though, has been rebuilt. If I remember it right, only in 1999 it had been destroyed. The pretty much only thing original here, from what I remember reading, is the old big pagoda. This one is pretty old. Hall showing the relics found here. Prayer Hall. Well, this main hall is quite impressive, but mainly impressively big and golden in the statues. The wood cuttings on the side of it all along are quite nice though. Those are good work and I think still a more traditional one than those majorly big statues. This mixture of old and new, of traditional and modern, is quite common here. It gets only stronger as we go further up the ancient T-horse roads route and the not so ancient, well, China hippie trail, so to speak, and the even more modern tourist trail to Lijiang and to the town which has renamed itself to Shangri-La, Shangri-La. Yeah, and it is something which actually needs critically thinking about, including critically thinking about the criticism of it, because that's often quite facile and hides a few things. Not least, one case we can look at is the chili and the corn, the maize, which is growing around here quite a lot, which are after all new imports themselves, but have had quite the effect.